lawyer's behalf.
Yes, sir. That would be a good move, sir.
Okay. So everyone is familiar with the bill. We'd like to solicit your comments. Maybe we can begin with the armed forces, and then later on we'll move to the other government agencies, and we can end with from our service herself, Lieutenant Colonel Arceo can also give some comments on the bill. Mayroon din po akong mga gustong makita sa batas na wala po in the current version. And in particular, we'd like to get Dole's point of view on one of my suggestions or one of my amendments to the current version filed. And of course, at the TWG, we'll also request the employers' organizations, maybe even the labor organizations to join. Kasi apektado rin siguro yung mga grupong ganoon, no? So, maybe we can begin with the Admiral Empedrad. Sir, do you have any comments for the bill? Meron po ba kayong gustong baguhin? Gusto pong makita na hindi nakita? O nakikita na dapat hindi makita?
Sir, this is just a clarification, sir.
Yes.
On page 1 of lines 13 to 15 of page 1, we just want to be clarified, Honorable Senator, sir. On the phrase, while the overall operation of their organizations are not severely prejudiced, just want to be clarified on what does it mean about this particular phrase.
Okay,
sir.
So Lieutenant Colonel Arceo helped us draft the bill, no? So I will refer to her in some of these matters. But there is nothing here set in stone. Meaning, kung meron mo tayong gustong pabago or clothing, we can, of course, use better language. No? Yun po yung purpose ng hearings natin. So, Lieutenant Colonel Arceo.
Thank you, sir. May I be clarified again which particular line you were referring to?
Page 1, line 14 and 15. While the overall operation of their organization are not severely prejudiced, what do we mean?
Just for everybody's perspective, most of the language here in text was taken off from existing relevant documents already. So this particular one is pretty much referring to how we refer and we treat our reserve officers, sir.
Maybe the question here is, which organization are we referring to? The employer's organization or the armed forces as an organization?
The employer's organization, sir.
All right. So, while the overall operation of the employer's operations are not severely prejudiced. So, I guess the question is, what if the reservist is a key personnel?
Correct.
Kailangan talaga siya to serve, and at the same time, mahihirapan din yung employer's organization. Does that mean that the employer can say, my operations will be prejudiced, I cannot let you go? I guess that's the Rear Admiral. Parang ganoon po yung tanong, ano? More or less yung clarification.
Sir, may I just enlighten the members of this group in terms of where the thinking behind this particular provision? It just meant that there are certain cases when an organization or a particular reserve officer is very critical, a critical member of the operations of a particular organization. And so, in case he is truly critical, but also at the same time necessary and critical also in rendering service to the AFP, the employer, the organization may opt to get a substitute. In fact, there are some provisions in the document that actually explicitly say so.
Maybe we can clarify the language, because it seems like the employer can say no. Yung dating is pwede silang humindi. Baka we can just clarify. We'll take note na lang of this provision. Which leads to a proper question. Can the employer bar the reservist from active duty? No, di ba? They cannot. Because there's a higher need, no? And of course, calling on a reservist to active duty is not done lightly, di ba? That's only during exigent circumstances and when the armed forces needs it, no? So, baka lang we need to amend this or correct it para it won't be misunderstood, no?
it may be perceived by the employers that they will always say that my organization is now severely prejudiced.
Yes.
So I might not allow you to go.
Yes. I think paros yung aming understanding ni Rear Admiral. Yes. So we can, we'll correct it. Okay. Any other concerns, Rear Admiral?
One more, sir.
This is one more honorable senator, sir. This is about...
You know, ko lang yung honorable yes, tayo. Informal mo lang tayo today.
Yes, sir. It's just a definition in page 2 of... line 8 of page 2 on active duty training. If we can just align the definition of active duty training to what was written in RA 7077,
okay,
would be good, sir.
To align the language, but the meaning ho is not naman, hindi naman ho nakaiba yung meaning, di ba?
Yes, sir.
It's more the language.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. No, no problem, sir. Anything else, Rear Admiral? Okay. Oh, baka meron kayong gusto ni share na kuro-kuro tungkol sa bill hong ito. I know that you're very,
yes, sir,
how do you call it? You're very invested in this particular bill, Rear Admiral. No? Baka meron kayong gustong, for the record, na maisabi.
Sir, I just want to make, I prepared the remarks actually for this particular meeting, sir.
Go ahead, sir.
If I may read it, sir. The AFP extends its utmost appreciation to the Honorable Senator, Senator Paolo Benigno Aquino IV, sir, for sponsoring Senate Bill 1607. Section 32 of RA 7077 provides for security of tenure in government or private employment while on military training. However, the said provision proved insufficient so as to ensure its application or implementation to concerned members of the reserve force. The Senate Bill 1607 amplifies and puts flesh to the said provision and therefore ensures that while our reservists were called to active duty, either through active duty tour of training or mobilization, they will not suffer the uncertainty of whether or not they can still go back and serve their former employer in the same capacity as when they left for said training or mobilization, or if their promotion potentials will be affected by the absence for work. We also put high hopes that when the law is enacted, when the bill is enacted into law, we will have a good working relations with the Department of Labor in the crafting of the IRR. We also would like to emphasize that the issue of the security of tenure is very contentious issues on mobilization of the reserve force, as it is beyond the capacity of the Department of Defense to implement. Our reservists, most of whom are volunteers, need constant training, but the uncertainty of the security of tenure hinders both AFP in general and the reservists in particular to acquire the necessary skill enough for them to seamlessly able to integrate with the regular force. This deficiency was evidenced during the mobilization of the reserve unit, which was mobilized during the Marawi crisis. Suffice it to say that in the current volatile, uncertain, complex, and ambiguous security environment, mobilization and employment of the reserve force is no longer a remote option that one hopes would never be used as it was in the past. Hence, the need to train and equip them in peacetime to enable them to support the regular force in crisis or in wartime is more important. The enactment into law of the SB 607 is much of important to us that it will be that it will eventually enhance the administration of our unsung heroes, the reserve force of the armed forces of the Philippines. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Vice Commander of the Major General.
Yes,
from
sir.
From the Air Force. Yes, sir.
Yeah. On behalf of the Philippine Air Force, which is headed by the Lieutenant General Galileo Gerard Quintanar Jr., which I represent now, we strongly support the enactment of this Senate Bill 1607 for the following reasons, which allow me to read, sir. The bill is in harmony with the general provisions of Republic Act 7077. It particularly strengthens the provisions of Article 6, Section 32 to 34, which is the manpower development of RA 7077, as well as the Labor Code, covering the security of tenure of employment of reservists undergoing annual duty training or mobilization. The law will tend to entice reservists to undergo ADT and other training programs, which will improve their skills and capacity to perform military duties. And with the enactment of this bill, mobilized reservists as well as those undergoing annual active duty training shall be more motivated and focused on their tasks, since they will be unburdened with the problem on security of tenure, of employment, and compensation. So the Air Force fully support this bill, sir.
Thank you. I'm sorry, Brigadier General Gabay, I forgot to recognize you. Kaupanan po yung paharap ko. If you have any comments, sir, or anything to say about the bill?
Just a manifestation, Mr. Senator. The Philippine Army fully supports the enactment of this bill, the Reservist Employment Rights Act, for it will help a lot. One of our most important programs in the Army, which is the Reserve Force Development. It is really intended to be the base of expansion of the regular force, particularly the Army, in cases of emergencies, just like the one in Marawi. That's why we fully support the enactment of this bill, sir.
Thank you, General. So, sa Marawi, ilang reservists po yung na na-require natin na sumama po sa encuentro?
We have mobilized one battalion in Danao del Norte and another company-sized reservist.
We'd like to acknowledge Senator Ligado, who is a reservist herself.
Yes, hi.
Senator, good morning.
Hi, good afternoon, ma'am. I was working in my office and they said you needed quorum and I didn't realize it was on the Reservist Employment Rights Act. So it's very, very, oh, and the Air Force is here. Very good. All the, yeah.
Senator Ligado, you are currently what rank in the?
I'm still a lieutenant colonel because of my MNSA, my master's in national security in 1992-93 in the MDCP. But now after my GSE, I just completed my general staff college, which is a requirement to be full colonel. So I'll just have to go through my paperwork in the Air Force. I'll have to see you after the holidays, complete the papers, and I hope in a few months. How long is the promotion, if they will promote me at all? I'm qualified for promotion to full colonel, and I'll have to go through the commission on appointments.
I'm sure we will say yes, Senator Laron.
And then the Majority Leader Fariñas.
You're all our batchmates, Senator.
I don't know, I didn't see them in class. I'm just kidding.
Thank you, Senator, for joining us.
No, I want to listen a while.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, Brigadier General Batao was just explaining how in Marawi, we asked one battalion of the service to join. Sorry, I'm a layperson. Ilan tao po ba yung isang battalion?
At the time, one battalion, we were able to mobilize 524 all in all. So 389 for that Lanao del Norte battalion, and another company in Misamis Oriental, numbering to about 135.
And those were all from the Army?
Yes, sir.
Yes, iba pa yung, did we mobilize from the other branches of the AFP? Reservists?
We did not mobilize any other units, sir, but some reservists individually were assigned to Marawi, like Colonel Manalak, Marquez, who provided information technology to the Marawi.
I see.
Marawi.
You don't usually put them in the front line, no? Hindi ko, no? This is more the support services.
In the rear operations.
All right. So none of them were actually in the battle zone?
No, none. Direct contact, no.
Oh, but definitely, those who are supporting from the back are not as important, but also important, no? In the scheme of things. Uh-huh. Yes, Senator?
The author, Senator Kino, the intent of the bill. Is it your first hearing?
Yes, this is actually a labor and employment hearing. This is a subcommittee of the Committee on Labor.
I was wondering, but you're hearing it because it's your pet bill.
Yes, and we worked with the reservists to craft the bill. There's an important amendment I wish to include from this version. Mm. But basically, this law supports our reservists who are called upon to serve, and we help them get back to their jobs, because there are times when the employers will say, hindi ka pwedeng sumama sa armed forces, sa patungkulan mo, kasi mawawala ka ng trabaho. Or if they get back, they experience harassment, or they experience maybe even a demotion at times, no, because of the time that they spent serving the country. So this will ensure their rights. But one thing I want to also include, Senator, which isn't here yet, is something similar to a maternity leave. Well, not 2 months, don't, huwag tayong ma-exout masyado, hindi ko 2 buwan. Pero kahit siguro isa o 2 linggo na paid leave for a reservist who will go to active duty or for training. That's something I really want to see because, and paid for by the employer.
How about a reservist who's with government? So dapat, hindi rin absent. Let's say, I have to go on active duty.
Yes.
For my promotion, right?
You should be allowed by your organization, whether public or private. Yes.
President.
Yes. And you're not absent.
A senator not considered absent to go on active duty.
Yes. That's my. That's what I want to see,
this
Senator.
Apply to me.
Yes.
Okay. How many reservists do we have all over the country?
Ma'am, there are 392,000 reservists.
392,000. Not necessarily those who went to school. Could be yung mga ginagawaran dahil sa kanilang position, di ba? Marami dyan sa mga captains of industry.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Nakatanggal ho ba doon yung ROTC graduates? Or kasama doon yung ROTC graduates?
That includes the ROTC graduates.
But hindi yung ROTC ng time ko, ha? Na basta makatapos ka, reserve officer ka na. But yung talagang dumaan sa totoong programa? Does the 392,000 exclude maybe everyone before the NSTP? Everyone kasi that took up ROTC previous to the NSTP law, I don't think, and I'm part of that batch, no? I don't think we really took up the real training program that we should have.
Because when you graduate from the advanced ROTC, sir, it's an optional for you to join the reservist as an officer.
Exactly. So ito yung nag-opt to join the, yes, so this is not just those who graduated previous to the NSTP.
Yes, yes.
Alright, so medyo ano ito, talagang dumaan ito sa tamang training.
But if you look at the data, sir, from 1996 to 2016, there are 2 million graduates of the ROTC program.
So meron pa rin, no?
So there are lots. We can, okay. We can.
And these are the students who opted to join the ROTC. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
It was optional on their part, yet pinili pa rin nila na mag-ROTC.
Yes, sir. But okay. They are not active in the reserve force right now, sir.
Ah, so they're not part of the 392,000?
Some, sir.
Some. But they opted for the advanced?
Yes.
Okay, so meaning, in college, nagkusa sila ng sumama sa ROTC instead of NSTP, and then pag-graduate nila, nagkusa pa sila na mag-advanced.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yun yung gusto natin. Yun talagang may gusto. No? That's 392,000.
Yes, sir.
392,000, Mr. Chairman, are they all, lahat yan nag-aral? Hindi. Anong
yes.
Porsyento dyan yung honorary title na binigay? I'm not honorary, but given a title without having gone through the schooling.
I have not, I don't have the correct figures right now, ma'am.
Maybe you can submit it to the committee.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm not saying that the reservists who are given the title, who didn't go to school, are any less than those who went to school. Yes. So that we can see, sino ang nag, ano ba ang reservist training? What kind are, what are the various training for reservists, maliban sa MNSA? GSC, ano pa?
Yeah, ROTC is one of
ROTC.
Three branches of service do basic citizens military training on a yearly basis. Once they graduate, then they will be part of the reserve force.
Siguro i-break down yung 392,000. Ano yung may semblance of training and what kind of training? At ano yung dahil siya'y captain of industry or politician ay binigyan ng reservist title, iba yon.
Yes,
where does that person need to go to training? Hindi, binibigyan lang ng titulo eh.
Yes, ma'am.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
But, I think if you're calling them to service, they have to have undergone training.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I mean, some form of training, no? Hindi pwede yung mga honorary. Kasi, but maybe the question, just to build on Senator Ligarda's point, of the 392,000, kung nagka-inkwento at kailangan talaga ng tulong, ilan dun yung maaasahan mo na makatulong sa armed forces? Is it also 392,000 or it's a smaller number?
I doubt, sir, if we can generate the 392,000 if the president calls for full mobilization.
Impossible.
I believe, sir, around 60, to be safe, sir, 60 to 70.
Yung readiness.
Yes, yes. Yeah.
So maybe in the TWG, we can stratify, no? Baka may select na pwede natin bigyan ng full, itong rights definitely for everybody. Pero yung kung magbibigay tayo ng parang paid leave, maybe it should be aspirational, like you have to reach a certain level to be able to qualify for a paid leave from the companies. na isang linggo o dalawang linggo na pwede kayong pumunta sa training o tawagin kayo to serve, and you will still be supported by your company. And anyway, later on, we'll ask for your opinion on the matter. No? Senator, we'll continue?
Yes. Can I go back to
you? Yes. Thank you for your support, Senator Legarda.
Yes, oh. Okay,
oh, that's the second reservist today, para pang babae. Di ba? Okay. Si John is the other reservist.
Okay.
All right. Sorry, Brigadier General, no? Were you... Yeah, we were just asking about Marawi, no? So, mga 1,000 po yung tao na nahiling ho natin ang sumuporta.
Around we mobilized 544, sir.
Ah, 544, okay.
One battalion size in Lanao del Norte and a company size in Misamis Oriental.
All right, thank you, sir. Can you ask the Navy? Oh, was it already? Sorry, iba yung Navy. Yes, General Bio.
Yes, sir. Our manifestation this is that this the Philippine Navy supports, in behalf of our flag officer and command, supports this bill that aspires our service to be more motivated and driven to undergo active military training or during mobilization be utilized during partial or full. And our service are very willing to undergo active duty training or more so to be mobilized. But one thing that hinders their mission is the assurance of having a regular employment after the mission. And General said the proposed provisions cited in the bill are very practical, beneficial, and protect the employment rights of reservist employees who are called to active military duty in the event of war, invasion, or rebellion, or to assist in disaster response. One reservist or any reservist can hardly perform his or her duties as a uniformed personnel in the active service if such reservist employee will have to contend with the idea of a probable loss of employment, needless to say, actual loss of pay and allowances, and thereby depriving their families of a source of livelihood. Indeed, there can also be a serious and irreparable damage on the part of the reservist employee and his or her family if her or his active military duty will adversely affect his present status, employment, position, pay grade, or potentials for future promotions. So this proposed bill reinforces the provisions of the implementing rules and regulations of Section 43 of RA 777, the security of tenure in government or private employment while on military training. We have that provisions already, the under RA 7077.
Thank you. Anyone else from the armed forces who wishes to share, state their position? Meron pa po. Maybe we can ask John from the Lieutenant Colonel John from the reservist point of view. You helped us craft this, so obviously you're supportive of it. But maybe you want to share a few words regarding the bill.
Thank you, Senator. And first of all, I'd like to recognize and give credit to the many gentlemen and officers who are here with us this afternoon as well. He has been with us, together with us, in actually preparing the first draft of this Senate bill. I will not mention each of them anymore, but we're very, very grateful to the senior officers and the higher authorities of the AFP, particularly the Office of the Reservists and Retirees Affairs, Rear Admiral and Pedrag has been very, very supportive, and we're very thankful for all the inputs of the different branches of service and other officers of the AFP, as well as the DOLE, who's been with us during the consultation, on behalf of the other reservists who inputted also in this particular document. We are excited, and we're all really looking forward to getting this particular piece of legislation passed. Senator, we have been mentioning in a lot of our meetings, formations, commanders' conferences about this bill, and we have felt the excitement of the other reservists, regardless of their ranks in the organization, for this particular bid, because there are a lot of us who are truly wanting to be able to serve in the context of security and defense of our country. So we're very, very excited. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Lieutenant Colonel John. I'm wondering why you're not in uniform today. Usually, naka-uniform ka pag may mga meetings na kasama yung armed forces. Para maiba lang.
There was no official
order to wear your uniform.
There was no official order from, okay, from the AFP, sir.
If you give her an official order, every day ho yan naka-uniform para itatabi na yung ibang bamit. No? Bale, Attorney Saura, were you part of the initial group that put this together, Attorney Saura?
Unfortunately, sir, no. It's actually my boss. Unfortunately, his flight was cancelled. So.
And your boss is?
Director Benjo Santos M. Benavides.
Director Benavides, yes. So I guess, dumana to sa inyo, so already very supportive of this bill.
Yes, sir. Firstly, the department supports the noble intention of the bill. During the drafting, it was already noted of the article in the Labor Code, renumbered as Article 301 or previously 286, which provides for the rule to be observed in case an employee is already called to military duty. It provides that employment is not deemed terminated, and that upon the finish of the service, reinstatement is mandated. Without, of course, diminution and the loss of seniority rights.
And correct me if I'm wrong, Attorney. Kung ginawa natin itong batas, and a reservist experiences that, na demotion, natanggal sa trabaho, bawal nag-serve siya, because of our law, the company becomes liable at pwede silang kasuhan, right?
Yes, sir.
So that in effect is one of the things that we're doing. It's a legal protection for our reservists to be able to serve and to be able to come back to work.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Also, however, the current law does not provide for or govern in case of government employees. There's also no clear rule of wage and allowances and a prohibition on against discrimination and violation of the employer-employee relationship.
Okay, can you state that again? Because we will definitely add that to the version. No? So the first thing you stated was?
There's no rule
For government. I think the intention is both public and private, no?
Sir.
Yes, Lieutenant John. Lieutenant Colonel John.
Mr. Chair, first of all, we are very, very grateful to Director Benjo. His input was very substantial and very critical to this particular deal. In fact, it has been raised, and we regret that the CSC is unable to send a representative today. Consultation with the CSC or the Civil Service Commission is very critical in the finalization of the draft of this particular piece of legislation, sir. Because just like what the good Senator Legarda mentioned, it should and must cover even those in government service.
I agree. So that's one. Yung pangalawa is the...
There's no clear rule on wage allowances.
Okay. I want to hold that discussion because I want to go into that discussion later, no? And the third is what I was talking about, yung how it affects the employer-employee relationship, no? So we can have a provision such that a violation of this violates the employer-employee relationship, the rules regarding employer-employee relationships, no?
Yes, sir.
So can you help us, Attorney, with the language? Para I think the intention is there, but maybe the language might be lacking, no?
Yes.
So can Dolly help us craft those provisions?
It's our pleasure, sir.
Okay, thank you. Anything else, Attorney?
The department, however, defer to AFP on matters regarding the reservist program.
Of course, but I think in matters in terms of mga employer-employee relationship, mas magandang si Dolly na yung magsulat para sa atin. No? So if you can help us in the TWG, I think pare-parehas naman yung ninanais natin. No? Okay, thank you, Attorney. Anything else?
Should I address already the paid leave?
Let's get there. No? Let's get to wage and paid leave in a bit kasi yun yung gusto ko pang makita na hindi ko pa nakikita dito.
Thanks, sir.
Alright. Pag-ibig, GSIS, PhilHealth, SSS, you all just mentioned in the bill. Do you have any major comments or in general, you're all supportive? Attorney Narvaez?
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for inviting us to express our position. Just two things, Your Honor. First, we want to manifest that we just received your request for our position paper, and we haven't filed our position paper.
It's okay.
In view of this, Your Honor, may we request for additional time to submit our position paper?
Yes, kahit after Christmas na, okay naman. So, first week of January.
Okay, thank you, sir. Second thing, sir, we just want clarification on page 8, section 12, lines 5 to 9, Your Honor. We just want to clarify if this means the government contributions will be...
Who's paying?
Yes, Your
Honor. Okay, yes, we'll get there.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Because I think ito yung part na kailangan ng konting... pag-uusap pa, yes, which is what Attorney Sara had mentioned also.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Okay. Attorney Yu?
Good afternoon, Honorable Senator Aquino. Thank you for inviting the GSIS. Certainly, we find no major obstacle why we do not, will not support the bill. However, we just want to have a few suggestions to enhance and improve the wordings of the bill and also to really make it work. As mentioned by Pag-ibig, like section 12, lines about the provision on the contributions shall be deemed paid and remitted and not reflect any gap in contributions in the records. We just want to be clarified, just like Pag-ibig.
Who's paying?
Who's paying? And if we want to suggest also that instead of saying deemed paid, it would be better that the government service of these government employees will not be affected in the sense that they will still be in the payroll. Their salary will still be paid. And perhaps with coordination with the civil service, they can be considered as on official leave, such that the contributions for Pag-ibig GSIS will still remain and continue to be remitted. Rather than saying that it is deemed paid and remitted, it will create some confusions and disruptions,
yes,
for the others.
Definitely, Attorney, we will improve the language, no? But initially, I think we need to agree on what we mean. We will get there. I think it's a similar concern to Attorney Narvaez. So if you can hold off that concern. Any other concerns?
Section 6 also, military service shall not, number 2, section 6, military service shall not be considered a break in the employment, etc., etc. And this can be correlated with the earlier provisions. On the condition that the contributions shall remain continuously remitted to the agencies concerned.
We'll see all of this in the position paper, no? So all of your comments, if you can write it down,
yes,
so we can act accordingly.
Yes, sir.
All right, thank you, Attorney.
Phil Health? Last time to
write yes.
Position paper.
Yes. First week of January. Yes, Phil Health, then SSS.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. Same concern din po sa part po ng PhilHealth na dapat po ma-define lang po na mabuti po yung kung sino po ang dapat na mag-shoulder po ng premium sa kanilang health insurance po. Hindi po malinaw pa ito dito sa draft na bill po.
Thank you.
And sir, if we can still go back to the first concern that was raised, yun po sa first page po yung na-raise po. Yung sa line 14 to 15, that's the first concern that we discussed. Siguro po ay yung pong linya dun sa line 14, yung while the overall operation of their organization are not severely prejudiced, I suggest completely ay tanggalin na po ito, but not to delete, sir, but to transfer to that particular provision on the option of the employer to hire an additional employee so that their operation is not prejudiced.
It's a better suggestion, no? So, kumbaga, ang napuperwisyo yung kumpanya, they're allowed to hire on a short-term basis.
Yes, sir.
And DOLE will not penalize them for doing that, no? Basically. That's the winning compromise. But in no way should a company stop a reservist from entering active duty if called upon. Correct.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Baliano.
Sir, for both government and private employers, sir, magiging concern po nila ito. Kaya maganda, sir, talaga mag-invite po ng private sector employers. yung concern, sir, na bawa on inactive tinawag po ng estado para po magsilbi, edi siyempre po hindi siya ituturing na ano na gap na po, and therefore for the part of private employers, they will have to continue, no? Para lalabas, sir, they will have to continue paying.
Well, that's something you clarify, because I think may mga past, may mga options pa tayo dyan.
Yun lang po, sir.
Thank you. Pernie Junior, anything?
Magandang hapon po, Senator. Nagpapasalamat po kami at nagkikibahagi po kami sa pagtalakay nitong batas na to, at nagpapasalamat kami sa oportunidad. Similar with the other GOCCs, but we want to clarify and underscore the following, because as far po as the SSS is concerned, we have a basic concern to raise, that is with regards po sa SSS coverage ng mga reservists po natin. Under the SSLU po kasi, ang military service is an employment in government that is expressly excluded doon po sa definition ng employment. Ibig pong sabihin, if you are connected to a government agency, in the definition of the military service po, ano, basis sa draft bill, malinaw naman na this is a service to the state. So sa batas po ng SSS, hindi po ito saklaw. Ang ginagawa po natin, we have this facility naman sa charter that they be not considered as compulsory or mandatory covered, but they can opt po for voluntary membership. During the period po na nagtatrabaho sila sa, or nagre-render po sila ng active duty training or military service para sa gobyerno. Yun nga lang po, may mga pagkakaiba-iba po pagdating sa coverage at saka sa benepisyo. Kasi po, kung ang isang miyembro ay employed o covered employee, necessarily, yung employer niya po nagbabayad ng 10 peso para sa employee's compensation fund. So, if in the course of his military service, something be fall, namatay po siya, nabalda, na-aksidente, o kaya nagkasakit, work-connected po antimano ang treatment doon under existing guidelines, at doble po ang natatanggap ng isang miyembro. Meron po siyang easy benefits na nakukuha. Pero pag voluntary member po, wala pong easy coverage, wala pong employees compensation fund coverage ang isang voluntary member. So ito pong distinction na ito may bearing patungkol po doon sa benefit entitlement. We just want to highlight this because yun na nga po, in our initial assessment of this provision, specifically section 12 lines 5 to 9 in page 8 of the draft bill, we see a concern unless it amends po the express provision of section 8, paragraph J, specifically item number 4 of Republic Act number 1161 as amended by RA number 8282. But in general po, we support the bill.
So thank you, Atty. Maraming salamat.
We will just formalize, sir, po our comments on this so that perhaps this specific provision can be further enriched. And
yes, maybe what we can do is we can try to agree kung ano yung scheme. No? Kasi maraming iba't ibang scheme. Eh. So let's try to agree on the scheme, and then we'll ask the TWG with all of your help to craft the proper language. Or kung ano man yung kailangan i-amend na batas o gawa ng exemption, we can agree first on the scheme, no? Okay, so so firstly, thank you for to all the resource persons for providing your inputs. And ano pa naman, probably one more hearing tayo to listen to some of the employers' organizations because sila ho yung wala dito. No? But right now, Lieutenant Colonel John, you can help me, no? The scheme is, kung, by the way, if I'm called to active duty, can I say no? You cannot, diba? No, we cannot say no, no? So, but you choose who to call. Brigadier General or Rear Admiral. You choose who to call. Marami rin pwede tawagin, pero pipili-pili ninyo kung sino yung i-activate ninyo. And those that you activate cannot say no, right?
It's because it's a voluntary thing, sir. If you want to be to serve in a particular unit, then they will ask you to be called to active duty. It's not actually mandatory, sir.
So you can say no.
It's a voluntary thing.
So manggagaling dun sa reservist.
Yes, sir, because it will affect your... Yes,
kunyari ho, itong nangyari sa Marawi, yung 500, alam mo yun, 590, 544. The 544 sila yung nagsabi na we want to serve or tinawag sila to serve.
They were called to serve, sir. Different yung mobilization, sir. If it is mobilized by the president, it is the unit that will be mobilized. The members of the unit will be mobilized. And that's mandatory, compulsory, sir. You cannot say no.
So being part of the reserve is voluntary, but yes, when you're part of the reserve and you are called to action or called to duty, you cannot say no.
Yes, sir.
Correct, no? Okay, so I just want to clarify that for the record. All right, so the current scheme is that kung volunteer na ako, I'm already a reserve, I'm working in government or the private sector or the academy, kung saan man, wala namang pinipili yan, di ba? Pwedeng religious sector, pwedeng abogado, pwedeng doktor, pwedeng nasa gobyerno, nasa pribadong institusyon. Tinawag ako, the law basically says, tinawag ka, umalis ka, eventually babalik ka rin, pagbalik mo, hindi dapat nagalaw yung status mo as an employee of the organization. I think we all agree there. So, kung baga yun, check, no? Habang wala ako, meron ba, sino ang nagbabayad ng sweldo ko? O ano yung sweldo ko habang wala ako? I think originally, the idea was, you have allowances from the military. Is that correct, Lieutenant Colonel John?
Yes, sir, but I think our officers Admiral Alpidot would be in the best position to actually discuss this, sir.
Okay.
So technically, yes, if you are called to active duty, there is a remuneration allocated to
okay.
you.
Well, Admiral, is this remuneration a salary? Is it an allowance or is it a per diem?
It depends, sir. If you are called to active duty, you should be paid the paying allowance that is equivalent to the rank that you are holding, sir.
Okay. But is it a salary or an allowance?
It's a paying allowance. All the benefits that is given to a regular officer will be the same, sir, if you are...
No, we're talking about magkano, di ba? I'm talking about ano yung status niya. For example, do we have to declare that as income tax? Or is it an allowance na parang per day mo na... na per diem, na parang expenses mo?
Yes, sir. It will, if it is paying allowance, sir, it there is a particular tax.
So it's salary?
Yes, sir.
It is salary.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I'm just clarifying. And take note, we can change things pa. Pwede pa rin baguhin po. Ito ang i-clarify. No? But right now, kunyari, yung 544 yung nag-silbi sa Marawi, and they were there for 2 months, meron silang 2-3 buwan na sweldo na katumbas ng kanilang rango. Yes, okay. So, as an employee, Attorney Saura, currently, meron akong sweldo bilang pribadong empleyado, and for 2 months, meron akong sweldo bilang sundalo. Is that correct? Parang ganun.
Well, Your Honor, mukhang pag yung if the policy na titignan po natin or the current, we have the policy of no work, no pay.
Okay, so ibig sabihin mo hindi na responsibilidad ng kumpanya mo na pinanggalingan mo mabawaran ka, right?
Yes.
So I get no remuneration from the original company, but my salary then becomes from the Armed Forces of the Philippines.
Yes.
No, correct. Okay, so kung meron akong contributions, yung PhilHealth walang problema kasi may PhilHealth ka whether public or private, no? Correct? Yung pag-ibigyan, no? Whether public or private. So meron ka pa rin contribution. Am I correct, no? So it's not a problem whether the salary is coming from the armed forces or from your private company. The problem then becomes GSIS and SSS. Kung GSIS ka na talaga, hindi rin problema. Kung government ka, kasi government, GSIS to GSIS.
Yes, Your Honor. Although currently the military is not under GSIS.
In my view,
it should be clarified if, as I earlier stated, pwede siyang considered as official leave, meaning to say walang effect sa salaries and status niya on the government. For example, GSIS, we had some reservists. If it is called to duty to military, assuming may sweldo din siya doon, and then allowances, whatever, the GSS will still be continuing his salary and deductions kasi on official leave siya. Now, we want to know this position of civil service kasi pwede naman siguro ganyan.
Okay, I don't think that's a problem. No? In fact, we just have to state it eventually. No? But ang GSS at SSS contribution, magkakaiba yan, depende sa sweldo.
Yes.
Right? What if CEO ka ng kumpanya, so mataas na yung SSS mo, pero ano bang pinakamababa sa reservist?
Lieutenant.
Lieutenant, no? Lieutenant ka sa reservist, so mas mababa na yung contribution mo, di ba? So, do you have any suggestions on how to, ano, how to, so for that month, mag-iiba yung contribution mo sa akin?
If I'm not mistaken, sa GSS, we usually choose the higher, kung anong mas mataas na salary.
Yeah, mas mataas na contribution ng empleyado.
Yes.
Ng empleyado. So, because, okay, so, ibig sabihin nun, yung sweldo niya bilang isang lieutenant, for example, iba yung computation. Kasi mataas yung kanyang GSIS contribution because it reflects the previous GSIS contribution niya.
Yes, and the allowances and salaries as reservists will be an additional compensation for him also, subject to civil.
No, but wala ka ng compensation from your, ano eh, from your current company.
Ah, okay.
Di ba? Kasi sabi nga ni Tony, no work, no pay, no? Although later on, I will propose na meron kang parang paid leaves as a reservist na later on.
Subject to qualification by civil service, I think if official leave, you can still receive your salary. Kasi official.
Ah, so for government.
Official business, with leave with pay sa amin.
Okay, so maybe for government, we can make a provision, not leave with pay. Anyway, government naman yan eh, di ba? Okay, I think I will carry that, no? Para peace yung mga gobyerno, wala silang problema sa marami na service mo yan, general, no? Okay, yes, sige, si Attorney De Sunia muna.
Thank you, sir. Sa amin po, I just would like to share na we capture only up to the maximum of 16,000 na per month as the monthly salary credit. So yung income na po yun ng isang private employee or self-employed or voluntary, hanggang dun lang yung nakaka-capture po namin. But having said that po, again, just to emphasize lang po, again, the basic issue for us really is this military service to the government, because that is expressly excluded in this.
Yes, which is why when we make the law, we might have to make some amendments.
Yes, sir.
But okay, just to go back. So from government to government, meaning non-armed forces to armed forces, pwedeng official leave, meaning with pay, and then plus meron ka pang allowance or that will be considered double compensation naman, no?
That is something that I would like the civil service to clarify also.
Okay, sige. So we'll park that question, but kung government, palagi ko pwede naman yun, di ba? Kasi, ano naman? Anyway, it's for the same goal, di ba? Okay, so we will park that pending a Civil Service Commission response, no? Because that could be considered double compensation also. Meron kang sweldo from two government agencies, but we can settle that. Okay, but currently, if everybody will agree, ang gusto nating scheme for government is official leave. So wala kang problema sa state status mo in the government agency, plus meron kang allowance from the military. Pwede rin kasi na lahat ng ibibigay sa mga reservists, because it's a short time only, are allowances as opposed to salary. I mean, that's one way to go around it, no? Para hindi nila kailangan i-declare yun sa income tax, di ba? As a daily allowance. It can be a daily allowance. Yes, John?
Mr. Chair, well, yes, that will have to be clarified because currently there is an existing law, there is section 7077 that really, how do you call that, mandates the AFP to actually give remuneration to the reservist that is called to active duty. So
yes,
those are the things that will have to be, well, either reviewed and sorted out.
But
you're right, I think given this in this context, it would be good if it would be paid leave, considered paid leave for the government employee.
Okay, so for government, right now, ang status quo natin, it will be an official leave. Ang tanong na lang, is it double compensation or not, no? And pagdating sa GSIS to GSIS, you can make naman through the computer, I guess you could easily make the adjustments such that in the end, hindi naman ganun ka-complicated. What's possible?
If official leave kasi, then there's no problem. Then the government employee still is considered in active service to little sweldo, pati remittance.
But technically, may isa pa siyang sweldo.
Yes.
Kasi the original law, it's in the form of a salary.
Yes.
So, may sarili kang GSIS contribution on the second salary?
Wala na ho.
Wala na dapat.
I think the scheme that I earlier stated is much simpler because if ang military mag-limit sa amin, mas complicated because military is not under GSIS na.
Oh.
Another way of doing it is that assuming there will be a violation against double compensation is what the civil service rule called secondment, wherein he will be considered in still in government service pero sweldohan ng military. And yun, the military will be the one to remit using the rate ng naiwanan na, especially if mas malaki yun.
Okay, sige. So we can, anyway, thank you for participating in this discussion, no? But we'll figure something out. Yung SSS, kapag private to government, currently walang provision for that, no? Okay, if you were to craft the provision, how would it go?
We are hesitant right now to suggest that the exclusion be amended or be done away altogether because this is what we call in Social Security Administration as anti-selective practice also. Kasi nga po, pag tinanggal natin yung government employment in considering SSS membership, eh, hindi na ho kami na iba sa SSS. Precisely the model that differentiates the GSIS and the SSS is the type of employment.
Okay.
We cater po to the private sector employment, whereas the GSIS expressly caters to government employment.
Okay, but we can imagine na 25 years akong SSS, tapos mayroon akong 45 days na GSIS. Di ba? Parang it doesn't it's not practical, eh, no?
Mr. Senator, sir, meron naman pong facility, meron pong iba-ibang klaseng types of membership sa SSS which can be availed of. Anyway po, kung ang pag-uusapan is the short-term benefits, magko-qualify naman po ang isang reservist. Yun nga lang po, kung long-term benefits ang pinag-uusapan, especially if the periods contemplated in regard to the military service are what we call qualifying contribution periods, baka po ma-prejudice.
What is a qualifying contribution period? How many months?
For example po, sa retirement, in the minimum, you are required to contribute, to have contributed at least 120 months. Kung naka 118 ka lang po, and you are called to active military service itong 2 months na ito, yun po yung sinasabi ko na yung 2 month na yun will be the qualifying contributions, which could spell entitlement to retirement benefit or not. Sana okay. Hindi po ma-prejudice siya doon. Kaya pwede din po siyang patuloy mag-contribute on a voluntary basis.
Mm-hmm.
On a voluntary basis. Ito po yung ginagawa ng mga nagtrabaho sa gobyerno and nag-transfer sila sa private sector. Para po kung kumulang or even vice versa po, yung nauna yung private employment nila, nagtrabaho naman sila sa government, just to complete po the qualifying contributions to entitle them to benefits.
Okay, so it's possible. So you're saying it's possible hindi ka kailangan lumipat sa GSIS. You can have a new category na parang voluntary ka na muna habang nasa armed forces ka, something like that.
Correct, Mr. Sir.
Alright, so kunyari, 5 years ka na in your company, tatawagin ka ng 2 buwan, sumusweldo ka sa AFP, pero meron ka pa rin, but your status for your social welfare, for your social security, still SSS, just another category.
Yes, sir.
In another, but you have to pay that.
Yes, sir.
On your own.
Papa.
Kasi, hindi naman mag-remit siguro yung armed forces sa SSS, no? I don't think it's going to happen, diba? So you will have to pay it on your own. And that wouldn't prejudice your qualifying period na parang nabibitin yung mga months mo. Pwede pa rin siyang i-cover or isama dun sa qualifying periods mo. Okay, so that's something we can craft, no? Okay, so in short, right now, so we all agreed, walang prejudice to your work status. Pag lumipat ka, merong funding po ang buwang military para sa iyo. Hindi naman issue yun, no? General, no? Hindi naman issue yun. That's budgeted every year, no? That's not a problem. Yung status mo for government, pwede kang on leave, so you don't have to leave anyway. Government naman yan. For the private, we have to craft the language such that your qualifying period won't be prejudiced, but you'll transfer to another kind of contribute membership for that short period. Okay, so clear na yon, no? And attorney, okay naman tayo dun, no? Walang yes, violation of any labor laws or rules there, no?
Wala naman, sir.
Okay, so the question ko ngayon, which I would like to raise, is I was really hoping na meron tayong certain number of days na pwedeng paid leave ng both public and private. Similar to like a maternity leave, like a benefit leave for the reservists. So that every year, mayroon akong X number of days na pwede talagang ibigay sa servisyo na ang kumpanya ko yung nagbabayad. No? That's really something I would like to see. Now, that's why I wanted the employers' organizations here. No? Ano sa tingin ninyo? Do you think it's a good idea? Because I have raised this before, but it didn't come out here in this version. So, meron bang tumutol or will this complicate matters? Kahit isang linggo o dalawang linggo for the reservist. And if you want, pwedeng hindi rin lahat, pwedeng meron kang, you know, at a certain level, you achieve this benefit, no? Yes, sir.
When a certain employee goes on a paid leave, then he will be given a corresponding pay for that paid leave.
Yes. Parang sick, di ba ang sick leave, ganun, di ba, attorney, no? Kahit may sakit ka, you have X number of days in the year, kahit hindi ako papasok, dahil may sakit ako, as long as limitado yan, I still get paid the regular amount, no?
Yes, yes.
So, similar to that, or a maternity leave.
My question only, sir, if, since he will be receiving pay allowance with the armed forces, since going on paid leave, so parang dalawa
yun. Ang naisip ko, well, of course, I'm assuming na mas mataas yung sweldo niya sa,
yes,
sa private work niya, is maybe kunyari after 5 days on the 6th day it becomes the actually ang magandang tanong dyan, yung to be able to keep up with your training, ilang days in a year ba yung required sa'yo na pumasok ka sa training para lagi kang up to date? Okay, yung preparation yun, how is that usually done by the reservists now? Alam ko they go on weekends, di ba? So most of them, Saturday, Sunday, 15 weeks, or 30 consecutive weekends na pag isang araw. Okay, and na-fulfill mo ba yan ng mga reservists natin? Are they usually able to complete the 30 days?
Most of our reservists, when they are on ADT, they were able to...
They complete the 30 days.
Mr. Chair, that's the reason we wanted to push this particular piece of legislation. In other words, we want to be able to help the AFP train properly and rigidly the reservists so that they will be ably prepared for whatever duty they'll be tasked, you know, in the event of any situation, secure situation that we might have. So that's the reason why, and it came from our regular officers, that it is important for a reservist to have a continuous non-break training. So and that's the reason we want to be able to protect and ensure that they can actually take off from work for a prolonged period, let's say 2 weeks, or in this case 30 days, or a maximum of 60 days, without any prejudice to their employment, so that they can be properly trained, and so that they become more able and competent officers.
Mm-hmm. Well, okay, so the training is another question altogether, because, syempre, iba yung na-encounter pa, at kailangan mo ng tao, iba yung training na pwedeng schedule throughout the year, di ba? Now, obviously, 30 days straight will be hard for any company to lose an employee for 30 straight days, which is why I think most people do the 30 straight weekends, no? Pwede ba yung malimit, kunwari, ano natin, meron kang pero parang hindi feasible yung 30 straight days na mawawala, no?
Yes, sir. Thank you for that statement, sir. Actually, in the previous workshop that we did in consultation with the other reservists who were here, who were themselves employers, they actually had the same position on the matter. And so we discussed among with the regular officers that what would be the minimum. They suggested at least a week, 7 straight days of training would be appropriate.
I think that's something that's very doable, no? Now, the other question is, yung sweldo ng reservist, does it kick in during training or it kicks in during active duty? Because maybe, I don't know, sa training lang po ba may allowance na? Sa training pa lang may allowance na?
Meron na? For training, sir, they receive laundry allowance, clothing allowance. And
pero hindi pa yung sweldo.
No, not
so. Okay. So, okay, because wala yung, that will not affect the salaries or contributions, no? So, okay. So how about this? And this is all just brainstorming at this point. Pag-uusapan pa naman to at isusulat pa, no? So, what if we push for a 1 week paid leave for all, or for the reservists that the armed forces feels is of that rank already or of that category? And then the rest of the training that we need to do, which is another 23 days, for example, they do on their own time. So meaning their other leaves or weekends, and walang sweldo during this period, only allowances. But if they're called to active duty, that's when the allowances come in, that's when the salaries kick in. So the employees will stop paying the employee, even though retained yung kanyang status as an employee, but stop muna yung kanyang pagbayad kapag active na, and then that's when the GSIS SSS provisions kick in. Is that no problema ba doon?
Actually, sir, yung nilikened po kasi po natin with maternity or paternity solo parent leave, yung purpose po kasi nito is a social welfare legislation. So, at yung ano po niya, yung outcome na gusto kasi po ng mga leave na po yun is the reintegration of the females in the labor market. So, kung dahil po ganun yung purpose niya, and at that time, of course, the employers groups mas cost yung iniisip. And I think, kung of course, I will not be able to speak for them, pero yung again, pag paid leave po kasi cost yung
of course yung for the well employer. Okay, I only referred to maternity and paternity as the scheme, not the purpose, ah. Baka iba yung purposes niyan, but just to refer to it as a scheme where you have a paid leave and it's mandated by law. Now, this is not a social welfare, it's not for social welfare, it's for national security. And what we're saying is that we need the reservists trained and capable to be able to pursue the agenda of national security. So, in a certain extent, this is the employer's contribution to national security apart from paying their taxes. No, I mean, that's pretty clear, no? That's the purpose here. And to be frank, 5 days, kasi kung 7 days naman yung kailangan, technically you can have 9 straight days if you start on a Saturday, and the next, that's 9 straight days, eh, but, and then the rest, paunti-unti na lang throughout the year, so that's 5 working days. 5 working days for a reservist, I don't think is too much to ask. Of course, we will ask them, no? We will formally ask the employers kung ano yung kanilang opinion dito. But in the same way, but much to some of their chagrin, yung paternity na itulak natin, yung maternity na extend natin, siguro naman maintindihan naman nila. And hindi naman to lahat. Pagkaligit lang yan, maybe even if it's just 30% of the 300,000, let's say 100,000 workers out of, how many workers are there in the Philippines? 16 million? 15 million?
72 million.
Ang nagtatrabaho?
Yes.
Oh, di mas malaki pa. 100,000 out of 72 million. 0.000 something percent lang yun, no? So, you know, I'm gonna, of course, kung ano naman yung ilabas natin dito, we'll see how they will respond. Eventually, kung maglalabi sila sa ibang mga congressman at senador, but kung ano naman yung ilabas ng committee natin, let's already push for for something yung ideal, diba? Let's push for something ideal and then let's see how far it goes, no? But at least with this group, that idea na meron pang five training day, paid training day or something for the service, and then meron pang another 25 days na kailangan mong kunin through your own means, assured or no discrimination or no changes in your work status, tapos kung mag-active ka for government official leave and for private, a scheme na hindi mawawala yung SSS contributions, but you get your salary from the armed forces. In general, are we agreeing to this? Or meron ba tayong gusto pang makita o magdagdag? Kasi what we will do, once we agree, mag-TWG, pag-uusapan, amen dito, but more importantly siguro, attorney, if you can help us, kunin yung point of view ng mga employers groups also, para makapagsalita rin sila.
Yes, sir. We have the National Tripartite Industrial Peace Council.
But what we can also do siguro, Rear Admiral, is, kunyari, hindi naman to for the 392,000. It can be for a smaller number. And then every year, we agree on the number para hindi rin siya, parang hindi siya unlimited yung dating. Baka kasi sabihin, mamimigay tayo ng mga leave sa mga tao, di ba? Para talagang pili-pili or you reach a certain, I don't know, number of training days, rank, or whatever, no?
If I may, sir, there's what we call ready reserve units. Out of the 400 that I mentioned, sir, around 70,000 to 90,000. So the leave may be applied only to these ready reserve units because this will be the one that will be deployed in case of disaster.
So ito yung crucial na dapat train lagi, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How do I become a ready reserve compared to just being a regular reserve?
If you are in the first category, 18 to 35, sir, you must be placed in the ready reserve unit. So itong ready reserve unit yung immediately can be deployed when called to active duty or mobilized by the president, sir.
So pwede mo, no? So we can, if everybody agrees, pwede yung classification natin. Yes, Lieutenant John.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, we probably need to define it further, sir. You are correct in terms of that category and definition of that category. Now we're clear on that one. However, there are instances when a reservist age-wise does not fall anymore under the category one, which is ready reserve, but they are very much able and they're actually needed by the organization or the AFP, for example, for certain requirements and certain tasks. So for example, the sanitary guard obviously does not fall under category one anymore.
Obviously?
I'm sorry.
For the record, yeah, huh? Please, from the record.
Yes, please start from the record. Pardon me, sir. I apologize to the senator. Obviously, like myself, for example, obviously does not fall under.
Tututulong kami sa obviously din sa yan. Tututulong kami. Okay, pagbibigyan naman yan.
But they are necessary.
Maganda with crafting a law is that. At this point, before the amendments come in, before the process moves further, at this point, it's really up to us. So you can be ready reserve, and you know, and those that the chief of staff determines, at you know, kung ano man yung language, no, but pwede naman, we can do that.
If I may, ano sir, yung RRU kasi sir, composed of mostly 18 to 35, but those who are above 35 can be part of the RRU as long as they are volunteering their services. So, what I'm referring to RRU is a specific unit that can be readily deployed.
Yes, and that can be the choice of the armed forces who deems to be ready reserve or not. Okay, sige, so, yes.
Sir, I just wish to formally manifest, if I may suggest that in the definition of terms, we clearly define active duty tour for training. This is to align, as you said, Admiral Pedrad with 7077. No? We define clearly active duty tool for training and active duty for mobilization. So those are two. In the context of the discussion right now, I think we need to define it and identify, differentiate those statuses. Reservist statuses in this particular Senate bill.
Okay. So kung wala namang magsasabing iba, which is what I suggest, no? We go to PWG, we'll ask for the support in getting the employers' organizations, attorney. Kung papayag naman sila sa 5 days, at hindi naman sila tututol doon, as long as formally they can say that they are in favor, we don't need to call for a second hearing anymore. We'll incorporate all of the suggestions already into the substitute committee report. Tama ba nang? Substitute bill? Substitute bill and have that as the committee report. Hopefully by end of January. We resume here on January 15. So if we can kindly ask everyone, maybe first week of January or second week, magkita-kita ulit. Attorney Sarah, please, alam ko yung director ninyo is helping us a lot, no? So, we would really need to get a point of view from the employers' organizations and from civil service, no? Yung dalawa pala.
Considering the chairperson of the NTPC is the secretary, so we'll try to coordinate with the
sure.
committee.
With Secretary Bobo? Yes. So, wala naman
I want to agenda it. For
yes.
Discussion.
Please do your internal arrangements already. But we're hoping you can help us get clear or be clear with the employers' organizations because, syempre, we need to have their point of view in our approach also. So if they agree and civil service agrees to the changes that we talked about, we can go for a substitute bill committee report already by the end of January. Hopefully get this passed by February or March. No, we go on break on March 23. Sana by then, okay na tayo dito. I don't think anybody would really oppose this. No? Siguro yung Congress lang. Sino ho bang, do we already have a counterpart in Congress? Wala pa. Have you worked with anyone in Congress?
We reached out to Congresswoman Marika Zamora already.
Okay.
She's gone over, she's asked the staff already to go over the draft. Mm-hmm. We still need to await the feedback from their end.
Okay. I don't think anyone will really oppose this. Ang key lang dito is to find out where it will be referred to in Congress. Because, to be fact, nagulat ako na labor and employment yung referral. Akala ko sa kay Senator Honasan, no, sa defense. But anyway, it was referred here. So, we'll try to have this out in committee by second week of January. Senator Villanueva may choose to defend this himself, or if he chooses or if he requests me to defend it, I'm very happy to defend this on the floor. And hopefully, before we go on break in March, at least sa Senado, pasado na. That's my timeline. Na? And usually, you can ask anyone here, usually mabilis kami yung gumalaw. No? So, hopefully, we can get this out as soon as possible. But yung pinaka-immediate step will be the employers' organizations and CSC. And we'll ask the secretariat and my office to do the necessary meeting such that by second week of January, we're either our output is either the committee report or a second hearing. Kung tutupon sila, we will definitely need to have a hearing because we will need to have their opposition on the record. Even though we might push through with this, even with their opposition, but definitely, if they will oppose, it needs to be on the record para fair, no, para fair to all parties. So, with that, let me thank everyone. Meron ba bang gustong huling hearing? Yes, Jan?
Thank you, sir. So I just wanted to reiterate that, you know, this particular bill is most important, especially with the advent of the mandatory ROTC. So the implementation of the mandatory ROTC at the senior high level is pushing through. And so, you know, moving forward, of course, with all of this youth get going into employment later on and they want to be able to be very active on the service, they should be able to help them as well.
Well, regarding mandatory ROTC, again, I will reiterate my position. I don't think it's RO.
Yes.
It's mandatory civic training or military training. senior high school. Grade 12 is 16. Would a 16-year-old really lead a battalion? They won't, diba? Your reserve officers, I think, comes from the professionals, comes from people who are working. Para lang fair yung titulo at yung talagang mandato nila. If it's a mandatory type of military training or civic training, I think that's fine. But once we start calling our senior, our 16-year-olds reserve officers, parang it's just not, you know, it's just not, I mean, yun yung nakagistan natin, that's the tradition, but I don't think it's the correct terminology, you know, and it's not practical also. Especially that if we have ROTC, siguro if we do that by next year or next year, edi may, ano, 8 million kang reserve officers bigla. Diba? It also hampers the budget for the reserve officers because the terminologies don't match. So I would suggest that there's a type of training for them. Although I think that the what we go to the Department of Committee on Education, not to this committee. And then you reserve the reserve officers for those who really have gone through the training, who are ready to lead, who are ready to join the... I don't think you will invite any 16-year-olds to a battle zone even at the rear. But general, no? Dito natin gagawin yun eh. So anyway, that's for another issue altogether.
We really just want to encourage and motivate the, well, the professional reservists.
Well, I think the five-day leap will motivate a lot of them. And I think, again, I don't know who in the armed forces does the communication campaigns. Of course, Jan's, that's your profession also. But talking about, you know, doctors, lawyers, politicians, priests, teachers who also serve, I think will be one of the best ways to get people into the reserves. Secondly, meron kang recognition by government, which is a 5-day paid leave for your continued training. I think that's there will be a sector, a specific sector in our society who will be very interested to serve at that level or in that way. Especially kung yung, kasi ang encuentro po, ayaw ko natin nangyayari yan. Pero ang disaster, wala tayong choice, nangyayari yan every year. No? So, if the marketing of it is also for civil defense, to serve during times of disaster, we'll train, marunong ka mag-first aid, marunong ka mag-rescue, I think we will be able to really grow the ranks of the reserve. And then, of course, we don't want it to happen, pero kung talagang kinakailangan, merong gulo na gawin sa Marawi, nandun pa rin sila na tumulong, no?
That's why, sir, it is important for us to include a section on advocacy in this particular document.
Alright. Okay, kung wala na po, kayo, yes, sir. Yes, you have one.
We would like to just express our gratitude, sir, for allowing the armed forces in behalf of our Chief of Staff, General Ray Leonardo Guerrero, sir.
Actually, it's the reverse. No? This is one of the ways we show our gratitude to all the service that you provide. Not, it's not the other way. It's our way to show gratitude also.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Maraming salamat po.